Welcome back, everybody. Interceptor here, seeing if we can get our winger at the command base. And if not, oh, something. Uh-oh. Oh, sweet. Wait, what was your name? Milo. Thanks, Milo. We'll take care of it. Maybe. Maybe we'll die. You just never know. Okay, we're up here. Do you have a winger for us? Oh no, what disappeared? Is that you? Oh, well, it's about time. Plana, you're here. Where's Chief Engineer Amatsu? I'm afraid we lost him. He was leading his men and trying to keep the morale up right until he vanished. When he heard you were in the city, he knew right away you'd be needing a winger. And he wanted you to fly one in tip-top shape, so he started tuning it one up for you. He looked so happy to be able to help, you know? Aww. Chief Engineer Amatsu, we promise your sacrifice will not be in vain. Find a way to bring you back! I promise. Though you're not vanishing as some kind of miracle, you must be blessed or something. Well, she's all yours and all parts are guaranteed or your money back. Only joking, she's to be, of course. And I got the Emperor's permission. You did? Where is His Majesty? That? I don't know. I got his approval before he left. I, too, had an inkling you need a winger at some point. Your knife for singer needs never ceases to amaze me, friend. Thank you, Plana. Life is full of surprise, is it not? Oh, I almost forgot. I'm coming with you. What? Can't let her out of my sight, you see. She's like one of my own children. Are you sure, Plana? Where we intend to go, we may never return. Think waiting here to become lost myself is any safer? Lana's got a point. Besides, I need to make sure my baby gets you where you need to go. I don't know how to thank you, Plana. With you on board, our chances are a whole lot better. Well, here we are. And that's scary. He's in there. That's where Krom is. Why am I not surprised a monster like Krom would build such a monstrous fortress? And yet he didn't. He borrowed it. This is a restoration of a building from my era. A monument to failure. It's Krom's way of showing off how much power he's taken from the moon. Power to restore whatever he wants from any time he chooses. The power was never meant to be used this way. It sounds like it's going to break in two. We may not be able to hold it together before we reach our destination. The winner's not going to be able to make a good landing. We'll have to jump out in our Vulcan suit. Oof, duh. Ready, guys? Not at all. Zero. Readiness level zero. Looks like our suits held out, but just barely. Who'd have thought that ancient relics such as these could be useful in this way? Is this the moon's will, I wonder? Krom is inside here. Come on. Okay. No. Well, this is scary. Welcome, everybody. To scary land. Scary monsters. Wait, look at those. Are those Imperial Vulko suits? Kind of. I think it must be Lord Zamorod and his men. He must have figured out the cause of the fragmentation and gone ahead of us. But yeah, they look evil. What, Baldra? What's wrong? There's something odd about them. They're not moving like normal Volko suits. They're evil.
I know the reason.
I'm certain they're being affected by the fortress. Day, this fortress was a symbol of wrongdoing. The force field here was designed to take control of motorized armor. Since Volko suits are based on motorized armor, they are affected in the same way. The Volko suits are under the control of the fortress. That's pretty crappy. So they're under Krom's control, and he's trying to get us to kill each other. Ha! Symbol of wrongdoing sounds about right. Bloodthirsty system built by war-crazed rulers who didn't trust anyone. He's talking about you, Oboro. The Empire's tactic of numbers isn't going to work in this force field. Our Volko suits are still working. Volko suits over a certain strength level are unaffected by the force field. I surmise that your Volko suits are no problem.
That means that all the other Volko suits in this area are...
We're all soldiers of this fortress. No, soldiers of Krom, I should say.
For now, we just need to keep moving. We can't afford to hesitate or be sentimental right now. Let's go.
Oh, goodness gracious.
We need to get up there to hit that switch.
I wonder if this is the last fortress in the game. Seems a little short. Counter laser.
LAD program.
You did a lot of damage with that punch. Just like to point that out and say congratulations, Luna. Oh, I need to do my Volko suit. Oh, okay. That's another we need to switch. Okay. Okay. Here we go. Well, actually, let's go ahead and hit that switch. Look! There's a way I can go now. That's nice. That's just a quick way down, I think. Oh, interesting. I think that's an elevator. Come on.
Good. what a patrol bot does, but I'm worried it's gonna like... You missed it? It's flying right in front of your face, Galdra! Please kill it, Luna. All you do is miss that thing. It cannot be that hard to hit. Seriously, I know it's flying, and that's hard, but really. There we go. That's thinking, Galdra. That's thinking. Okay. Ah! Switch! Ah! Okay, let's go this way then. Well, that's nice, I'm sure. Most of my Japanese is from anime, which I think is pretty normal for a person my age. But that's still funny. Maybe I should bring in some of my magic dudes to try and kill these guys a little bit faster. Not Poppy. Good work, Galdra. Oh, that treasure! Lame! I like the design of this fortress, though. I actually, like, in general, I would say that I do quite like the design of... the areas of this game. I do feel like they're pretty... unique and interesting and all that kind of stuff. You know, all the dungeons don't look the same. All the bosses don't look the same. Volga suit. Volga suit. Volko, Volko, Volko. Ooh, endlessly foolish. Yeah, mortals are dumb. Apocalypse, oh goodness gracious me. This is getting foreboding. On that, let's actually wrap this episode here and see if, in fact, we are going to face the apocalypse. Until next time, Interceptor out.